In today's video, we're going to cover the best electric guitars for beginners. Let's get into it. Welcome back, folks. This is Shane. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell. This video is not sponsored or anything like that. So if you enjoy the video or get some value out of it, let's see if we can get the video to 1,000 thumbs up. Really appreciate that. This is, I think, part 6 or something in a series like this. So if you like this video and it's helpful, links will be up in the cards to the entire playlist. So in today's video, we're going to cover, in my opinion and experience, the best beginner's electric guitars out there. Now, these aren't cheap junk that you'll regret buying after a few years. These are guitars that I could play live, or someone else could play live, or even more experienced players than me could use and still go, you know what, this actually plays and sounds great. So this, in many ways, is the best alternative to spending a lot of money on an electric guitar if you're a beginner. So let's get into it. The first guitar I have to put on this list is the Squire Classic Vibe series of electric guitars. Now, they have a number of different ones, but I'm going to put two in particular on here with a little bit of a caveat on one of them. So the first one I'm going to put on this list is the 60s Squire Classic Vibe. I owned one of these. I bought them when they first came out, and it's such a great guitar. You get all the stratty tones. The sustain on this instrument was almost unparalleled. It's a beautiful sounding Stratocaster. Had a nice neck as well. It was a thin neck, but it was a nice neck. Quality Tone Rider-esque pickup, so it had a lot going for it and it looked the real deal. It just looked beautiful. It had that two or three tone sunburst, and it also had the tortoise shell pickguard. These particular electric guitars are in both left and right handed as well. So no matter if you're a southpaw or regular sort of regular player, righty player, then you should be good. You can do anything from Dire Straits to classic rock to blues to funk. It will cover just about every style of music. So the 60 Squire Classic Vibe, beautiful guitar. I'm also going to throw in the 50s Telecaster into this first one, because the 50s Tele from the Squire Classic Vibe range is another great instrument. The only small downside to it is they weigh an absolute metric ton. I think they've gotten heavier over the years. It's crazy. I first purchased one of these when I was in Florida. I packed it up in my suitcase, unbolted the neck, got home to Australia, hooked it all back up, and didn't have to change a thing. So they're really robust, reliable, and quality instruments, just with that small thing about being a little bit on the heavy side. But if you want something that's not quite as heavy, go for the Strat. I'll leave links below. Now, if you're starting out, you might not know exactly what kind of sound you like, and that's why this guitar is next on the list. In terms of price, this is actually far cheaper than that of the Squire Classic Vibes, but you're still getting a really solid instrument. And if you have to, you can potentially upgrade some parts down the line and still get a really great guitar. But they still play and sound great straight off the shelf. In Australia, these are dirt cheap. I'm sure they're going to be cheaper just about everywhere else other than here. These are the Yamaha Pacifica 112 or 112. These are great instruments. The only small criticism I have of them is the toggle switch can feel a little bit cheap. So that would be the first thing I would upgrade potentially if it had any issues. But the pickups and the neck, everything about this guitar in terms of playability and tone gets the big double thumbs up from me. I've had a chance to review these almost every single year, and they're awesome. For a sub $300 guitar, depending on where you live, they're going to be an absolutely great guitar. You get the two single coils in the neck, and you also get a humbucker in the bridge. So it potentially covers more styles of music than the Squire Classic Vibe. If you're into heavier stuff, you're going to get a kick out of the bridge humbucker. It's one of the best, least expensive guitar humbuckers I've ever played, and they feel really good to play. The major difference between the Yamaha Pacifica and the Squire Classic Vibe is the finish on the neck. You get more of a natural finish on the Yamaha instruments as opposed to that on the Squire. They get those sort of vintage high gloss necks. So depending on which one you like the feel of the best, I'll leave some links below so you can check the photos out online as well, because these instruments, I think, are some of the best out there. And if you're a beginner, you'll have no problems learning on a guitar like this. It won't make it any more challenging than it should. Up next, we have the Harley Benton CST24T. This is a kick-ass guitar. This is so good. This is based on the PRS SE Custom 24. Now, I own this, and I've still got the PRS SE Custom 24. And they were so close to each other, it didn't justify me owning both. I ended up selling the Harley Benton, but that doesn't mean it wasn't a great instrument. It absolutely was. If you're a right-hander, you can also find them with P90 pickups, and they sound absolutely awesome. So in terms of what was around when I first started playing, there was nothing as good as the CST 24T from Harley Benton. These guitars rock. They've got 24 frets. They've got a fairly flat fretboard radius as well. So more of that modern thing. Great sounding humbuckers. A little fatter actually than the PRS counterpart in terms of its tonality. I did an AB between them as well. And there wasn't enough in it to really make me want to keep both in the end. The PRS SE Custom 24 is more expensive and it has that name brand recognition, but in terms of like a blind test shootout, there wasn't much of a difference in terms of how they played, how they felt. And I actually got to take out the CST 24T and play it live. It was just like playing the PRS. If you're looking for a dual humbucker guitar that can basically cover any style of music, look no further, check these ones out. I think they're one of the best electric guitars for their price on this list. Up next was a guitar that was only available in Australia up until recently. They've now opened a US store, which is cool. This is the Artist Guitars LP59 CSB. And if you're a lefty, put an L on the end. I'll leave all the details in the description. So this particular electric guitar is based pretty much on a Les Paul. It's that kind of guitar. It has the Bullbucker pickups, which are a huge upgrade. The Bullbuckers are basically like the Burstbucker style pickup and they sound fantastic. This is one of the few guitars out there that has a really usable split coil tone on it. Even in comparison with far more expensive guitars from Epiphone and Gibson, this guitar was great. Now, they didn't always start out great. The first few that I tested of these, I actually sent back. About a year went by and they sent me one of these new ones with the Bullbucker pickups and the build quality, the tone, everything was really great. Now I've done reviews on all of the guitars so far in this list, so you can find them on my channel just by typing in the guitar name and in the blues and it will come straight up. This is a really great instrument. Now these are also very similar to some of the more premium guitars from Harley Benton. Harley Benton make very similar guitars to this, just with some different aesthetics and pickups. So I'll leave links to both below and you can take a look and see what you think. But overall, just in terms of tonality, feel, this is by far the best inexpensive Les Paul I've ever personally played. Up next is a guitar brand that I would never have thought I would have owned two of these. These are actually really great instruments. I admittedly used to ridicule them because I used to see them in the bargain basement bin in a lot of shops like Cash Converters, which is a used buy, swap and sell kind of place. This is the SX range of guitars. Now they have a number of different series. The VTG ones are the ones that I've owned personally. I had a Strat and their Tele, and these are easily on par with the Squire Classic Vibes, but their headstock shape isn't for everybody. You're probably seeing some of that on screen right now as I've got videos on all of these guitars. So they have two things going for them that put them sort of ahead of the Squire Classic Vibes in many ways. Their weight. They're very light compared to the Squire Classic Vibes. Even the Telecaster is lighter. So if weight's a concern, you're gonna get a kick out of that. Secondly, they're about half the price of the Squires here in Australia. So you can weigh that up. These are guitars that aren't that common in like all locations around the world, but if you sort of do some hunting, odds are you'll find them on eBay or somewhere like that just used, because there's always a few of these popping up around town here and just about everywhere else. You can still buy them new too, but if you're looking for an absolute bargain, you'll find these for under $100 on the used market. So overall, these are about half the price of those Squire Classic Vibes. They also have, I think, the same pickups. I'm not 100% certain on that, but they sound pretty much identical. Using these guitars out in the live mix, the first time I got to play that SX guitar live, the Strat, I was like, man, this is so good. And then another one of my friends, he bought both of them as well. So it's funny just how great they sound. They set up well, everything about them's good. If you like a high gloss vintage style neck, you'll get a kick out of them as well. The only sort of downside to these instruments is the headstock shape isn't for everybody. So keep that in mind. I'll leave some photos obviously and video on screen, but yeah, overall the SX instruments are really, really cool. Go check them out. The next guitar I'm gonna put on this list is for someone who might wanna do something like jazz or blues or even classic rock. This is a really versatile guitar, probably more versatile than you might think. I owned one of these for many years and it was my main gigging guitar for a long time. This is the Epiphone DOT335. And if you so choose, the Epiphone DOT339. Now these are getting up a little bit in price compared to the rest of the stuff on this list, but these guitars are phenomenal. The 339 is essentially a very similar 335 style guitar, but smaller. And there's no lefties, unfortunately, so you're out of luck. But they make lefties and righties in the 335s, and they're very, very solid in terms of just being a great gigging instrument. One of the cool qualities about the pickups in the Epiphones is the fact that they're not overly bass heavy, which means you get way more clarity than some of the Gibsons I've owned and some of the Gibsons I've tested. So not all Epiphone pickups are better than Gibsons, and I'm not saying that they are, but with a 335, clarity is sometimes one of the biggest or first things to go when you plug those guitars in compared to any other sort of electric guitar. So in my opinion, the 335s are a great instrument for anyone who likes to play clean, off clean, through to a crunch tone. If you're into playing really high gain stuff, give these ones a miss. But in my opinion, and after using one for many years, they're back to having the good headstock again. So yeah, Epiphone went through this many years where the headstock shape was awful in a lot of people's view. I couldn't really care less about it, but a lot of people don't like it. But now they're back to the Gibson style headstock on a lot of their instruments. So if you can find one of them, give them a shot. And the one that I had many years ago, and you can still find them on the used market, had that exact headstock shape as well. So yeah, keep an eye out for these if you can find them. If you're looking for something a little bit different with really great sustain, you'll definitely get a kick out of these instruments. And they're absolutely gig worthy for people who are even more professional. You'll see guys touring with them. So check them out. The next guitar on this list is one that I absolutely fell in love with and had no expectations for. This is the Gretsch Electromatic Jet. Now, there's a few different models if you're a right-handed player or a left-handed player. I'll leave links to both in the description, but the one that I absolutely fell in love with was the Gretsch Electromatic Jet G5230. And this video went online a few days before this video, but I tested it a few weeks back. Beautiful sounding guitar. Everything about it tonally and how it felt and the build quality was unsurpassed at that price point, in my opinion. The pickups sound kind of like a Tele, but with a bit more attitude, a bit more like a mini humbucker sort of. Gretsch pickups have their own sound, right? So I'm just giving you a reference. They've got their own thing going on, but they're like a hotter Telecaster mixed with, you know, a mini humbucker kind of tone, that kind of thing. So the neck on this guitar was beautiful. It was one of the best necks I've ever played on any instrument, irrespective of the price, and it looked beautiful. It's just an awesome guitar. Now, one of the things that makes this different to, say, a conventional Les Paul is the fact not only do you get volume and tone controls on the guitar, but you get a master volume. So this means you can turn down your neck pickup slightly and keep the bridge one all the way up, so on both pickups, and then you can use a master volume to turn that up and down. This is a really cool feature that more guitar companies should use. So I'm still on the fence. I actually really want to buy this. I really don't need another guitar right now. Famous last words, right? I'm sure we've all been there. But I got to tell you, just looking at the photo of this on the video here. So this is what I do. I just look at everything that I've done videos for. I was just like, man, I want this guitar. So I might go back over the weekend, take a quick look at this and just see what happens. I'll see if they can crunch some numbers at the shop. But value for money, these are next to unsurpassed. They are a little bit more expensive than some of the others on this list that I mentioned, but they're still less expensive on the most part, and it's going to depend on where you live, than a lot of the Epiphone guitars, unless you're going to sort of like the lowest end Epiphones, which I don't recommend. So definitely check these out. Now, one of the things I've noticed when I do any of these type of videos is everybody in the comment section says, what about ESP? They make this, they make that. Now, up until recently, I didn't have a lot of hands-on experience with ESP guitars. While I haven't reviewed one on the channel, I'm yet to actually find a lefty. I've been able to find a whole lot of really cool right-handed guitars, and they make just about something for everybody at many different price points. So ESP have been known for years as sort of like a metal brand and for people who like to play, you know, heavy styles of music, but now they're making a great mix of stuff at all price points, and some of this really appeals to me both visually and just tonally as well. So they make a great looking Telecaster, which is the ESP LTD TE254, and this is in distressed three color sunburst. Now, not everyone would probably like a Relic style electric guitar, but for that price, they look and sound great. So I can highly recommend them. They also make a really great looking Les Paul style electric or LP style called the EC256. I'm gonna leave a list of a number of different types down in the description because they make SG style ones, Flying V style ones. I mean, these would never get confused with Gibsons if you just visually, but they make some really unique finishes, including the flame top, which has that lemon drop style finish on it. It looks really cool. Links will be below. So let me know what you think of this list. I've tried to make it appeal to different styles and different players and all different price points. Now, of course, I can't throw everything into this list. I've tested hundreds of guitars over the years, but these are the ones that really stand out to me in terms of tone and feel and price. Now, I could have added in some brands like Eastman, for example, but they're starting to get up there in price, and I already sort of filled that spot with the Epiphone, but you could sort of swap them in and out depending on the mood whenever I make the videos. But basically all these guitars will serve you well as a beginner. They won't make it any more challenging to learn, which is an awesome thing. And you could absolutely gig with them long-term and not have any problems. So links to everything will be in the description. I'll leave more information down there and you can check it out. A massive thank you to everyone who watches this particular series. Hope you're doing well. If you did enjoy the video, I got some use out of it, please give it a thumbs up. See if we can get to 1,000. That'd be awesome. Thank you so much. Catch you soon. See ya. Let me know what you think of the new camera.